Good morning and welcome to the Take Your Life Back Today Show. My name is Ralph Roots. I'm an addiction recovery coach, a life coach, and the host of this show, the Take Your Life Back Today Show. Today I want to talk about taking control of your life while in recovery. Here are 10 things that I want to talk about to begin the process to determine what course you would like to take if you were going to take control of your life while in recovery. First thing you want to do is to accept your past. The only way to move forward is to acknowledge where you've been and the role your experiences have played in creating who you are today, no matter what it looks like. The fact is that you would not be who you are right now if it wasn't for those experiences. And in some cases, they may actually serve to help you identify your purpose going forward. Number two would be to know what your values are in life. What do you prioritize your life in? What does it mean the most to you? Choosing the direction that allows you to live out a value that is close to your heart and what can serve to keep you motivated and inspired to stay sober is what you need to do, is to know what your values are. Number three is to identifying what you want to change in your life. Think about where you live or create a plan to where you might want to live. In some cases, you may be able to make simple changes in your life, but if you're working to take control of your life on a grand scale, you are going to want to map out a more detailed path to accomplishment and to accomplish those goals. It can help to make a list of all the things you want to achieve and pick the one that is the simplest, create a program that will help you achieve that. Number four is to identifying your motivation. And motivation is the key to anything in life. What keeps you going? Ask yourself that. Inspired? Are you excited? Manage your emotions. Emotional responses to situations, people, and sudden changes are normal, but they can stop you from being in control of your own life. But take a thought about this. What happens to you and how your life will proceed depends on your motivation and how you take control of it. We cannot control what others do to us, but we can control what we do to ourselves. But we somehow can respond to the changes in life what other people might try to do to us. In almost every case, a huge emotional reaction is going to complicate matters and cause more difficulties. Number five is to prioritize self-care. Getting good sleep, quitting smoking, getting to and maintaining a healthy weight, seeing the doctor regularly, getting regular dental checkups, undergoing recommended mental and physical health screenings, and making other positive changes to help you stay healthy will help you be the best you can be. And always remember to include God in no matter what course of action you take to be a better person. When you are taking control of your personal health and wellness, you are in a better position to take control of other areas in your life. What will you do to take control of your life in recovery and make your day-to-day experience everything you want it to be? Depends on you. It depends on how you accept your past. It depends on your values that you have set. It depends on what do you want to change. It depends on how motivated you are going to be. And it also depends on your self-care. These are the things that you need to work on each and every day. So take control of your life while in recovery. And if you're not in recovery and you're watching and you don't have addiction issues or you're not in recovery, taking control of your life by applying these items that I just spoke about. We all need to accept our past. It doesn't matter how we do it, but we need to accept our past because our past, believe it or not, makes us stronger for our future. We need to know and set our guidelines for what our values are in life. Whether you're in recovery or not, it doesn't matter. You need to know what your values are. And what do you want to change in your life is very important. For a lot of us, change is included. While we're in recovery, obvious change would be to get rid of what we are in recovery for in the first place. And the biggest change in my particular life is to accept the Lord Jesus Christ into my life. Because without my higher power, my God, I would be nothing. And then you need to identify what your motivation is. And no matter what your motivation is, utilize that as a springboard to making a better tomorrow. Pick up a passion. Whatever might motivate you is what you need to utilize. And then you need it to, if you're in recovery or not, self-care is very important for your health, self-care for your environment around you, self-care in general. Doesn't matter if you're in recovery or not. Let today be the first day that you start taking control of your life, whether you're in recovery or not. Let today be the first day of your new life. Call me at 844-405-HELP. We can help each other take our lives back. And remember, include God each and every day, no matter what you do in life. Whether in recovery or not, it doesn't matter. Include God, because for God so loved the world that he gave his only son. And you as a parent or a grandparent, would you give up your child for anyone? Well, God gave up his son to die for your sins, for my sins, for our sins. Let today be the first day of your new life. Call me at 844-405-HELP, and we will help each other take our lives back. And remember to always remember this. The power of prayer is the strongest ammunition you have in life for a better life. The power of prayer. Include God in each and everything that you do each and every day, and may God bless you.